Yo, what is up, guys? Zorin here with another Epic 7 video. Basically, in this video, I just want to talk about the new patch that's coming out today. So this video is going to be coming out today as well because, you know, I want to talk about the patch. Anyways, there's really not much to talk about besides a couple of things that I thought was interesting. That's the only reason I want to make the video, so I can give my thoughts about it. So let's just talk about it real quick. The other thing I wanted to talk about was Strahzit, but you guys already know what's going on with that guy. He's gonna be really, really good. Looking at his video, his S3, S2, S1, you already know what I'm gonna be doing with him. If I pull him, I'm gonna be pulling for him. Probably make a video on it because I do have a couple mistakes from the last video when I pulled for him El Kawaza. If you guys saw that, I'm probably just gonna hope I get him. If I get him, I'm putting him on a counter set. Right, that S1 counter set. Anyways, so for this video, we already know the arena is going to be ending soon. Skyward frame, this doesn't matter to me because I don't really do arena, so it doesn't really matter to me. I should probably do arena. Maybe I should do that for videos. What do you guys think? Leave a comment below. Maybe I should start doing arena, see what I can do, see how far I can get on for a season. Maybe make a series on that. Maybe. So yeah, arena. The set for this week, for this season, is gonna be effect resistance. For me personally, this is good for me because I've been wanting to build some support units that I should be building already. I always keep holding them off because a new shiny DPS unit comes out, and then I forget all about my support units that I should be 6-starring. Like my Mikoi is still 5-star since like 2 years ago. She's still 5-star. A lot of my supports like Diane. DN, Holiday Euphine. Well, she doesn't really need resist, but you get what I mean. Like a lot of my supports, I don't really have support, so when I go into RTA or stuff, I don't have anything to back me up besides maybe a few tanks. So this is gonna be good for me. Personally, I'm going for the ring and the necklace. Not the necklace. I just realized it has attack. That's a weird necklace. Anyways, I'm going for the boots and the ring first, and probably go for the rest. Maybe the armor and the helmet, but the sword and the ring, I don't know why they just copy and paste the sets. They should have some other stuff. Come on Smilegate, change the sets too. Don't keep them like this. This is just bad. Like why is this a thing? Anyways, so yeah, I'm going for the ring and the boots. So those are going to be the ones I want. So for the drop rate up we have right now, since, like I said, there's not much going on. Prowl and Holy Sacrifice with Ravi and Sigurd Scythe. I like the Sigurd Scythe. It's one of my favorite artifacts, especially for warriors. Prowl is really good for, you know, RTA, Guild Wars, anything, honestly. Wyvern Hunts, really good PvE unit as well. If you don't have him and been wanting him, he's not a bad pull. Holy Sacrifice is good as well. Goes with him, as obviously that's why they're putting him with Holy Sacrifice. So if you want to pull for him, it's not a bad thing. But just remember that the summer unit is probably coming soon, and the collab that got delayed, as you guys all know. But hey, free stuff is free stuff. So I'm not complaining. Free stuff is free stuff. Robbie's really good as well. I know she's really good in RTA now. Probably good in Guild Wars as well. I haven't been using her. I have her, but I'm not using her. Sigurd Scythe is really good. I really like that artifact. So if you know, like I said, pulling for them if you can. My rule of thumb is I like to pull. If I don't have them, I'll pull one time on each banner. Maybe get them. It's happened. I've gotten them like that. So you know, if you have a lot of bookmarks, just throw one at them. You never know. You might get them if you don't have them. That happens to me. Guild Wars Skyward season ending. Yep, Guild Wars is ending. That's great. I don't care, honestly. The thing that I really was interested in was the improvements. I haven't done the Kaidus Hunt or Sidus Hunt or whatever it's called at all. So this is interesting for me. I need to figure out a team. If you guys know a team, leave a comment what team I should be using for this, because I really don't know. I actually never done this hunt. I haven't even done Hunt 1. For it, so you guys can go ahead and help me out. I'll really appreciate it. But the golem set improvement is really nice. I like it. I might try to get an attack set for my ML Kawazu. I was gonna make a video on ML Kawazu, but maybe I still will. Maybe on Friday I'll make it. But for now, I'm not making it because mine's just scuffed as hell. But yeah, basically you want attack, just pure attack, pure defense stats, like defense and health and speed, and some speed as well. Get him really high attack. This might actually be really nice now looking at it. So I don't know, there's some other units that I was that might like the attack sets now. So health set is a nice boost too, and defense set. I have some units that I have on health and defense, so their HP and like my general perk is gonna probably be in the 30k's now, 31k maybe, with this buff, because he's wearing full HP set, so Wyvern's gonna be even better for me. Defense set, really nice buff as well. Very good buffs right here. Golem, I think this is a pretty nice buff, especially for the attack set. I think that's a really pretty neat buff. It's like almost like a tier 70 ring or necklace. Well, a right side gear basically. So this is nice. Golem, very nice. Sidus, I have no idea. Never used any of these. But a buff is a buff, and that's pretty good. I mean, I was hoping this the revenge set would get a better buff than this. But I guess, you know, a small buff is nice to just see, maybe that'll help it. But I was hoping maybe like, I don't know, maybe like an attack percent increase as well on top of the speed increasing. That would make it really nice. Like, not, it doesn't have to be a percentage of that percent, like speed. Like, I meant for every 1% of health loss, it could have been attack and speed increases by an additional 0.5%. Or maybe a little bit more for the attack, maybe 1% for attack. That would have been nice. I could have seen that happening, but I don't know. I'm not the balancing team. So, you know, I mean, they balance carrots, so I shouldn't be saying they're good at it. So let's not get there. Injury set. After attack increases the max HP by health 6%. I don't know if this is gonna help it much at all, but we'll see if anybody decides to build it. Penetration set is pretty cool. 50% instead of 10%. That's almost like what the that one 4-star artifact for thieves. So that's pretty cool. I mean, that's almost like a free artifact for that. So I think that's pretty nice. This, I think penetration is the one that comes out on top of, from all of them. I think revenge set comes in second, and then injury seat. I like I said, I don't know about injury set, but yeah, those are some good buffs. The equipment cost gold adjustments. Sorry, is really nice for artifacts and equipment. That's actually really cool. 50% reduction. Oh my god, I'm always running out of gold because of the enchantment. So this is a nice little improvement. Thank you, Smilego, for that. I hope you guys do it a little bit more, though. 15% more, you know, 30% would have been nice. But we'll take it, you know. Free anything is good. So thank you, Smogget. Free and equip buff, guys. This is gonna be nice. Maybe I'll try to make an ML Kawaza, like I said, on Friday, if I can beef him up with better attack sets. Cause your boy needs more attack so he can do stuff. But he's a really good unit, though. I'll make a video on him. Special change adjustments. Tapping on continuous changing specialty for I don't know anything about that. I really don't care about that. I don't use specialty changes, so I'm gonna leave it like this for now. And then there's just bug fixes and stuff. So that's really it for the patch. Then there's just, you know, Straze already. You guys already know about Straze, so I don't really have to talk about him. This is just gonna be a little thought video on what I think about the patch. That's really it. There's really nothing much else to talk about besides what I plan to do. So yeah, I'm probably gonna be doing some videos on my Abyss runs eventually. Probably no commentary. I don't think it needs commentary. I just want to put them out there to see. It's not gonna be a guide or anything. It's just me putting it up there for the sake of just putting it up there to see how I did it for future reasons, just to see, look back at my Abyss runs, how much torture I went through them. And then I'm probably gonna do an RTA, some RTA videos as well, because I need to get that Ruel skin now that I have Ruel from that one video. So yeah, that's really it. There's nothing really else to talk about. So thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the little patch rundown on what I thought about it. Please leave a like and subscribe if you guys want to watch some more Epic 7 content, like some Guild Wars, some RTA, some Arena, just leave a comment below. Let me know what you guys want to see in my videos. That'd be very helpful. And I also hope that my quality of my voice and my background isn't as bad as my MLK Walls video or any of my other videos. I've been trying to fix that for a while now, and I hope that now it's, you know, sounding much better. So thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys on my next video. Peace out.